Deciphering the secrets of the Enigma machine. The Enigma machine, a pivotal invention in WWII, originated in Germany in the 1920s. It was primarily used by military forces to encrypt communications, ensuring that sensitive information remained concealed from enemy forces. This cipher device was distinguished by its complex design, featuring a series of rotors, a plug board, and a lamp board. The layout allowed operators to input and receive encrypted messages through a typewriter-style interface. Central to the Enigma's encryption method were its rotors. Each rotor could be set to one of multiple positions, altering the electrical pathway used to scramble messages, thereby creating a vast array of possible configurations. Daily setup was crucial for the operation of the Enigma machine. Operators would configure the rotors and plug board according to secret settings distributed in key sheets, which changed daily to maintain security. The plug board, an additional component of the machine, offered another layer of security. By swapping pairs of letters before and after the main rotor encryption, it significantly increased the complexity of the cipher. Daily key settings were crucial for the operation of the Enigma machine. Each day, German military units received a new set of configurations, which detailed the rotor arrangement and plugboard connections to be used. These settings ensured that messages remained secure and could only be decrypted by intended recipients who had the same configurations. Setting up the Enigma machine required precision. Operators adjusted the rotors and plugboard according to the day's settings. Each rotor was placed in a specific position, and the plugboard wires were connected as instructed. This setup was fundamental to maintaining the secrecy of communications. As an operator typed a message, each letter pressed activated a corresponding lamp on the lamp board, indicating the encrypted substitute. This visual feedback was immediate, allowing for swift encoding of messages, which were then transmitted as seemingly random sequences of letters. The rotors inside the Enigma were engineered to move with each keystroke, changing the electrical pathway, and thus the encryption with every letter typed. This movement was critical, as it ensured that the same letter would be encrypted differently each time, adding a layer of complexity to the cipher. At the heart of the Enigma's encryption process was the reflector. After a signal passed through the rotors, it hit the reflector, which sent it back through the rotors on a different path. This mechanism was essential for the encryption and decryption process, as it allowed the same settings to be used for both. The Enigma machine's encryption complexity was significantly enhanced by the multiple rotor positions it offered. Each rotor could be set to one of 26 positions, and the combination of three or more rotors allowed for millions of cryptographic possibilities. This vast array of settings made it exceedingly difficult for unauthorized parties to decipher messages without knowing the exact rotor positions. Operators meticulously set these rotors daily, based on secret key settings distributed in codebooks. This setup was crucial, as even a slight error in the rotor arrangement could render communicated messages unintelligible, even to intended recipients. The daily change in settings was a fundamental security measure that protected against the risk of intercepted messages being decoded. During message typing, each letter pressed would cause the corresponding lamp on the lamp board to light up, indicating the encrypted character. This direct feedback mechanism allowed operators to quickly and accurately transcribe the encrypted message for transmission. The rotors moved incrementally each time a key was pressed, ensuring that the encryption for each letter was unique. This movement was crucial for maintaining the security of the system, as it prevented simple frequency analysis from revealing the content of the messages. The reflector, an essential component of the machine, sent the electrical signal back through the rotors after reaching it, but via a different path. This mechanism ensured that the encryption process was reversible, enabling the recipient of the message to decode it using the same settings as the sender. Allied forces began intercepting Enigma messages early in the war, setting the stage for an intense cryptographic battle. teams of cryptologists, linguists, and mathematicians were assembled to tackle the daunting task of decoding these transmissions. The introduction of additional rotors in the Enigma machine was a strategic move by the Germans to enhance security. This change increased the number of possible settings exponentially, making the code much harder to crack. Cryptologists employed various techniques to break the Enigma codes, including statistical analysis and the development of electromechanical machines like the bomb. These methods exploited the inherent weaknesses and patterns in the encryption process. Human error played a crucial role in the encryption and decryption processes. Mistakes in the daily setting of the Enigma, or predictable message content, allowed Allied codebreakers to make significant breakthroughs in deciphering messages. The use of the Enigma machine was particularly crucial in U-boat communications, coordinating attacks and evading Allied naval forces. Breaking these codes gave the Allies a strategic advantage, significantly altering the course of the war. As the war progressed, adjustments to Enigma protocols consistently challenged Allied codebreakers. The Germans frequently changed the rotor wiring and daily keys, creating a moving target that required continuous adaptation from the Allies to keep up. The creation of the bomb machine by Alan Turing and his team marked a pivotal turn in the battle against Enigma. This electromechanical device was designed to expedite the process of finding the correct Enigma settings, dramatically cutting down decryption time. The capture of key Enigma codebooks from German U-boats was a watershed moment, providing the Allies with much-needed insight into the encryption settings and procedures. These captures allowed for a quicker and more accurate decryption of Nazi communications. Ethical considerations surrounding the secrecy and deception in code-breaking activities during WWII remain topics of debate. The use of intercepted communications raised questions about privacy, the morality of espionage, and the lengths justified in warfare. As the Allies improved their decryption techniques and tools, the effectiveness of the Enigma machine began to wane. By the end of the war, what was once considered an unbreakable code had been systematically dismantled by persistent Allied efforts. The Enigma machine's secrets were fully unveiled only after World War II, revealing the extensive efforts by Allied codebreakers to crack its codes. This disclosure showcased the pivotal role of cryptanalysis in modern warfare. The legacy of the Enigma machine in the field of cryptography is profound. It not only highlighted the importance of encryption, but also sparked advancements in digital security and cryptographic research that continue today. Museums around the world now preserve Enigma machines as historical artifacts, allowing the public to glimpse into the once secret world of wartime code breaking. These exhibits serve as a tribute to the cryptologist's ingenuity. The Enigma has inspired numerous cultural works, including films, books, and exhibitions, capturing the intrigue and drama of its history. These portrayals help to educate and fascinate audiences about its critical role during WWII. Modern encryption technologies owe a debt to the principles demonstrated by the Enigma machine. Today's secure digital communications build on the legacy of the Enigma, enhancing privacy and security in an increasingly connected world.